This video is the second of three that go with section 43 of Hansen and Quinn's Greek and Intensive course, and it covers the passive voice in the subjunctive, the optative, and three tenses of the infinitive. You can refer to Hansen and Quinn pages 111 to 122 for their coverage of the material, and they revisit it in the appendix on all sorts of pages. To form the present subjunctive passive, you go to the first principle part where you go for all things present and will need endings. Let's look at our favorite verb, luo, luso, elusa, leluca, lelumai, eluthane. And we go to the first principle part, make a stem by taking off the omega. And now we're doing the passive, and here are our passive person markers. Since we associate the subjunctive with the primary sequence, we'll be using those person markers. So here are your endings. Omai, a, atai, omitha, aestha, ontai. See how you've got those passive person markers, the primary ones, on the long vowels, omega and eta, of the present subjunctive. In the second singular, we lose the intervocalic sigma, and then the vowels contract together, and the eta eats the alpha and sticks the iota underneath. Accent is recessive, and we have progressive repeated aspect. Remember, no translation until we have context and know what kind of clause we're translating the subjunctive in. Here's what the forms look like all put together. Luomai, lue, luetai, luomitha, luestha, luontai. Check out the second singular. Lue can be present subjunctive passive second person singular, as in this paradigm, or you are freed, the second singular present indicative passive, as we learned in the last video, or the present subjunctive active, third person singular. Context will have to tell you which to choose. Use the genitive of agent to specify who's doing the action if you need to. The aorist subjunctive passive comes, as all things aorist and passive do, from the sixth principal part. And then we'll have endings. So here's our luo. And we'll need the unaugmented stem because we won't be indicative. So, to get the stem, we take off the ain, and we take off the epsilon augment. Now a place to put our endings. And, you know, I want to whip out our nice passive person markers, but actually I won't need them, because everything aorist and passive looks active. So here are the endings. And these should look familiar. O, ace, a, omen, ata, osi, or osin. Exactly the same as the present and aorist subjunctive active endings. You'll know they're passive because they'll be on the sixth principal part. Accent is fixed on the long vowel of the ending. So you might as well just learn the circumflexes on the endings. Simple aspect, and no translation until you know what kind of clause it's in. Put together, the aorist subjunctive passive of luo is lutho, luthes, luthe, luthomen, lutheta, luthosi, or luthosin. If you need to be specific about the doer of the action of the passive verb, you use the genitive of the agent. Let's move on to the optative. First principal part, as with all things present, and endings. So here are six principal parts, and we need the first principal part without the omega. We'll need a chart for our endings. This time, those passive person markers will come in handy. Optative is for secondary sequence, so we'll use the secondary person markers. Combined with the omicron of the present tense and the iota of the optative, you get oimein, oya, where you see the intervocalic sigma has dropped out of oisa, but nothing gets smooshed. Then on to the third person singular, oita, oimetha, oistha, and ointa. Accent is recessive, and its progressive repeated aspect. We have no default translation without a context for the optative. So let's see what luo looks like in the present optative passive. Luoimein, luoya, luoita, luoimetha, luoistha, and luointa. And you use the genitive of agent if you need it. To form the aorist optative passive, you'll need principal part 6, as for all aorist passive, and some endings. So, that will be from eleuthein, and we'll have to take off the ain and the augment to form our stem, because we're not indicative. Now for the endings. Alas, we can't look to the passive person markers, because everything aorist and passive looks active. So we'll have endings with epsilons that will start to look quite aorist and passive to you, and the optative iota, plus some quite active-looking endings. And they are aein, aes, aa, aamen, aeta, aeson. In the plural, the aorist optative passive has alternate endings you may see too. Amen, eta, and an. Accent is fixed on the iota, so you can learn it on the endings. In the regular forms, that's acutes, according to the rules for accent. In the alternate forms, because the accent will stay on the iota of the second to last syllable, the circumflex rule comes into play, and you can memorize the circumflexes on the endings. This is simple aspect, and we have no default translations since you've got to know what clause you're in first. So let's put that all together with luo. We get luthein, luthees, luthee, luthaemen, luthaeta, luthaeson. And the alternate forms, luthaemen, luthaeta, and luthaeon. And you'll use the genitive of personal agent if you need it. We still need to do infinitives, present, aorist, and perfect infinitive passive. Present infinitive passive comes, of course, from the first principal part, and our new ending is esthai. Accent is recessive. The default translation is to be being verbed, or, more usually, to be verbed. So you take your stem, lu, add the ending, esthai, and the recessive accent, and you get luesthai, to be being freed. The aorist infinitive passive comes from the sixth principal part, as do all aorist and passive things, and the ending is anai. Accent is fixed right there on the ending. It's a circumflex on the eta. The default translation is to be verbed. So we take our sixth principal part, unaugmented, luth, and the ending with the accent, and you get luthenai, to be freed. Finally, the perfect infinitive passive comes from the fifth principal part, as does everything perfect and passive. The ending is simply sthai. Accent is fixed on the penult, so that will end up being an acute if it's a short vowel, or a circumflex over a long vowel or a diphthong. To have been verbed is the default translation. So, you take your principal part 5 stem, lalu, and then the ending, sthai, and you put the accent over the penult, and you get lalusthai, to have been freed. As for other forms of the perfect passive, you can use the dative of personal agent when you need to specify the doer of the action of a passive verb, but genitive of personal agent still works. That concludes all the non-troublesome forms of the passive voice for the tenses and moods you know so far. You're ready to tackle drills and all the uses for the subjunctive, optative, and infinitives, and now that you can do them in the passive.